It was good. Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to give double honors to the apostles at GMS, Great Millstone. We out here in Columbus, Ohio. One of the raggediest cities on the face of the planet. Big piece of shit. That's what this city is.
Right. The Hebrew Israelites coming out here to teach these knuckleheads. But it's only a small
group. Oh, shit.
Brothers going to get this truth. The rest, which is the majority, ain't going to get it. Because the Most High condemned these motherfuckers, you know? All these motherfuckers just straight up just born to fucking die, man. Let me get this scripture, bro.
Cause this truth ain't for bitches. A lot of these men is just grown ass bitches.
This is wisdom of Solomon 1:1. Love righteousness, ye that be judges of the earth. Think of the Lord with a good heart, and in simplicity of heart seek him. For he will be found in them that tempt him not, and showeth himself unto such as do not distrust him.
Yeah, because a lot of people love to tempt the Lord. They love to talk shit. Well, the Lord is real. How about he strike me dead now? How many times you done heard that?
Right.
They be tempting the Lord too when they talk about the Lord done blessed them too when they wicked as hell.
Bless them with that blood money. Bless them with that blood money. And they right though. He blessed them. He gave them what their hearts desire in this world, which isn't spiritual gifts, it's carnal.
And the devil too. Oh, did y'all watch that Donald Trump speech? We got that his wife was reading the Lord's Prayer. She said the Lord's Prayer.
Say it again, bro. Who?
Donald Trump's wife said the Lord's Prayer.
Oh, wow.
So, because you know that's all an act. They're going to have to pay for that. They're going to have to pay for that. Going out there, that, you know what I'm saying? They're tempting the Lord doing shit like that. You know damn well he's not a man of the Lord.
No damn well. But they don't know.
But these people, yeah, they don't
know. You know? Hell, they probably don't know, you fucking idiots. These presidents are going to be. For forward thoughts separate from the Most High and his power. When it is tried, reproveth the unwise. For into a malicious soul wisdom shall not enter.
And he got a lot of malicious souls out here. That's all they thinking about. Because malice, that means evil. You know, that's where you get the word malevolent. What's another word? Yeah, malice. What's another word to go with that? Malcontent. Huh? Yeah, maliciousness. Hey, it just means evil, it means bad, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, in Spanish, mal means bad. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, mal. And these people, they ain't no good. They're not good, you know what I'm saying? They're all bad. Like a fucking, a rotten apple, you know what I'm saying?
Fucking evil.
Fucking evil.
For unto a malicious soul, wisdom shall not enter, nor dwell in the body that is subject unto sin.
Right, because that's why these guys, when you talk to the average person, they ain't got no knowledge. You can't have no kind of deep conversation with them. You can't talk about history with them. They don't know any history. The only history they know is the history of the NBA championships. That's all they know. That's their history.
Sports.
Yeah, sports history.
Sports.
We was just talking about the Byzantine Empire. These people never heard of that. You know what I'm saying? They're not even secret. If you try to tell them about it, they don't care. They don't give a fuck. Even though that's the history of our people. You know what I'm saying? We have a righteous kingdom.
For the Holy Spirit of discipline will flee deceit and remove from thoughts that are without understanding and will not abide when unrighteousness cometh in. For wisdom is a loving spirit and will not acquit a blasphemer of his words.
Yeah, we ain't gonna quit no blasphemer of their words. We're gonna cuss their ass out, man. We're gonna call them out on their bullshit. Yeah, we're gonna condemn them. You tell them the name of your house shot, they throw it back at you. It's like, that's that bullshit.
That's crazy.
That's why these people, they got hell to pay, man.
That's crazy. That's still mind-boggling. They come out here. Don't use the name.
Then you got you got people who know they Israelites and they reject the name. But they gonna get rejected.
For wisdom is a loving spirit and will not acquit a blasphemer of his words, for the Most High is witness of his reigns and a true beholder of his heart and a bearer of his tongue. Let me get this real quick. Right. Oh, you know what it is? I don't know what it's gonna spot. In Matthew's, convict himself with his own words.
He has Matthew 12.
Right, by his own words shall he be condemned, or whatever.
Yeah, I think that's 12.
What's up, bro? You know your Hebrew Israelite?
Sorry?
You know your Hebrew Israelite? What's your nationality? No. You're a Hebrew Israelite, man.
Africa's not even a nation.
What's
that's
original,
a continent.
What's Africa's name
after? Africa's Scipio.
Yeah, right.
Africanus, Scipio Africanus, right. A Roman general. Right. General.
An Edomite. So you're not an Edomite. You're a Hebrew Israelite. You know. So the devil, after the earth was given into his hands, he just started renaming everything, man. You know, and you start renaming shit, man. You can't find the truth. You can't, you know. You can't know your history. So what he got us thinking, we're African Americans. We're Hebrew Israelites. We're the people of the Bible. That's why we're out here doing this, you know what I mean? That's a clever way of miseducating us.
Because Israel, they fled the promised land. And they got scattered throughout the whole earth. And you had Israelites living all up on the west coast of Africa, all through Africa, all through Europe. Israelites ruled through Europe. King James of the Bible, he's an Israelite. See what I'm saying?
Let me show you something.
But our people, they lost their heritage. Now you got these devils over there in the state of Israel, they claiming that they're Israelites. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead, they heathen.
This is Galatians 4:26. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free, which is the mother of us all. So, you know, we ain't from Africa. From Jerusalem dispersed out. You know what I'm saying? We are in Africa though, our people.
All through Africa.
Right. We're all, our people are scattered on the whole
That's
earth.
That's not where we originated.
No, we originally in Jerusalem.
Jerusalem.
In Jerusalem. You know?
That's where the Garden of Eden was in Jerusalem.
Right. And we're the Hebrew Israelites. We're the people of Adam, you know? That's us. You know, even though other nations came from Adam, let me get that.
Yeah,
you
know? That's Ezra.
Yeah. That's a bad script. My mouth dropped when I first heard this scripture too. This is amazing, man. It's amazing. And it speaks volumes. This is 2 Ezra 6:53. Upon the sixth day thou gavest commandment unto the earth that before thee it should bring forth beasts, cattle, and creeping things. And after these Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures. You ever read the book, the Bible? You
know,
you read Genesis, how it goes through that order of creation?
Yeah.
Okay. Where am I at? Okay. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, of him come we all. and the people also whom thou hast chosen. So he just made a separation there. And the people, you know. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the Lord, the world, for our sakes. As for the other people,
I mean, all these other heathen nations, you know what I mean?
This is beautiful, man. As for the other people, which also come of Adam, thou hast said that they are nothing. You hear that? So the Lord looking at them heathens as...
like them Arabs, the so-called, even the so-called white people.
Africans.
The Africans. Like the Somalis. These, you know, Somali. You ain't related to Somalians, are you?
These ain't our people.
These ain't your people.
You got any family members that's participating in these activities? You see the... Nah, I know you don't. Because that's not our people.
And why do we look like them?
Because
at the beginning, every nation was dark.
Yep.
All the nations were dark, man. You know? All the nations, man. He just made a separation. So it's just when we started dispersing out, mixing with the other nations, that's when a lot of the shades... We were always different shades anyway.
Yeah.
You know? We were always different shades. That's when you come out with a lot of lepers, brothers, you know?
Cause, yeah, because light skin, that was a... the Bible don't call that, calls a leprosy. You know, in the Hebrew, got a different word in the Hebrew. But it's where there's laws in the Bible to go into leprosy and talk about how Israelites, they would catch the plague and they would turn all white all over their body, you know what I'm saying? And that was one of them plagues.
Lot, when he killed his brother, when he barked.
All right, here's the question. Yeah. I read the Bible twice. I grew up in a Christian family.
Okay.
I'm not religious at all.
We're not even.
I read the Bible twice from the back. Why is it such a big contradiction?
Give me one example of a contradiction in the Bible.
Any intelligent person that read the Bible knows it's just a big contradiction.
Okay, you just made a comment. Just give us an example of one of the contradictions. The Bible don't contradict itself.
It contradicts it if you
don't
know.
The Bible does contradict itself.
Right.
There you go.
Because Christian doctrine contradicts itself. Right. Church teachings contradict itself. But what we're teaching is the truth of the scripture. There's no contradiction.
So if y'all not religious, why do y'all carry Bibles?
Here, let me give you an example of Bible here.
The word religion is not even in the Bible. When you look in the original Hebrew Greek text, there's no word called religion in there. The Bible's all about nationality, about nations. This is the history book of the Israelites.
Right, but that's been rewritten.
It's been translated into different languages.
Right, but that's not the original Bible.
But we got the original, though.
That's not, but what y'all reading now is not the original Bible. Listen, I know that.
But we studied the Hebrew.
Y'all reading a copy of the Bible.
Listen,
y'all reading a rewritten version of the Bible.
Okay, but it was the Lord given.
But you have to study. But you have to study. You just can't be lazy. You have to actually go and try to learn the Hebrew and learn the Greek. So you know what I'm saying? Because you got to go to work. You know what I'm saying? It's not a lazy man's job.
So, right. So the proof plus, man, the Lord scattered us. He scattered us over here in this fucked up land. And we're speaking his tongue.
Yep.
English. So he gave us English to read so the people can understand. You know what I mean? And it's only the spirit that the Lord gave us dealing with King James to put it into...
Translators?
Use translators to put it into what you want to call common English or whatever, man.
Because, you know, originally, the Catholic Church caught you translating the Bible into English. That, you know what happened? They burnt you with a stake. So why would they burn you alive for doing that? Because they don't want you to get these words. They don't want you to know about your heritage.
Man, there were so many attempts on King James' life, man.
Yeah, they tried to blow him up in the gunpowder plot.
The
gunpowder plot of 1604.
Okay. Just for interpreting, because he didn't want the wicked didn't want the common people reading this.
No,
because of his power. You know,
that's why they didn't let no Bibles in the schools. But go ahead with that.
Isaiah 28:11. For with stammering lips and another tongue, will he speak to
now
this
Hebrew,
people?
Because that's our natural tongue is Hebrew.
Hebrew.
He said another tongue. Go ahead, please.
All right, that was it.
See,
yeah, another
man.
Tongue.
That's beautiful, man. That's a fast.
Because our people are scattered amongst all nations. So we got Bibles in Italian, Russian, you know, all them, all the languages.
Oh, yeah, plus, like the Muslims, we try to say that the Bible is translated to all these different translations, but the Muslim Bible has, like, never been altered. But think about it. Since the scripture says that the wicked rule the world, And the wicked is a wicked person, so he's going to hide the truth. So if you're going to hide the truth, what you going to do? You're going to try to keep trying to change it. Okay, I'm going to change this, I'm going to change that. Lord, see? That's bullshit.
And there are perverted translations, too, like the NIV. There's some translations you got to stay away from.
The Gay Bible.
They got, yeah. So we know the King James, you know, you can trust that. But there's still little things in there you got to learn about it in words that was mistranslated. That's why you got to study. You know what I'm saying?
That's beautiful right there, because it says right here in 1 Corinthians 2:10, but the Most High have revealed them unto us by His Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things.
Yeah.
Yea, the deep things of the Most High.
So at the end of the day, we get all the knowledge from the Holy Spirit. You know what I'm saying? What goes beyond this physical world.
Yeah.
And the Lord reveals things to you in the Spirit. That's how we know it's the truth. But the Lord revealed it in the Spirit. Because that Spirit bears witness that we the children of Israel. Because there's a people called the children of Israel. It's all through the history books. Now, where are they at today? You know what I'm saying?
Good question. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so, the things of the Most High knoweth no man, but the spirit of the Most High. Now, we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of the Most High.
Yeah, what's the spirit of the world? The spirit of the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life. It is the proud spirit. You know, the spirit is just want to do wickedness. You know, you can't trust nobody no more these days. You know what I'm saying? That's the spirit of the world.
You smell the spirit of the world now. Smell it.
Because our people don't care about nothing but foolishness. You know what I mean?
That's that loud.
That's that GMO dude.
That's just, hey, they got a good time coming, man.
But I know this, though.
You
do know that Bible you read and the Old Testament, the New Testament, the King James Version, all that, none of that is the original written Bible.
Well, what's that mean? What you saying? So just hell with it? So we should just cast it out?
I think y'all reading the wrong Bible.
No, but we like I said, we studied the Hebrew. But when we can't come out here speaking Hebrew. First of all, we don't speak fluent Hebrew. We can barely speak English right. You know what I'm saying?
I know I can barely speak.
But we study, though. We study, and we you know what I'm saying? We work hard at it. Because we know this is the truth. We know that we're the children
of
Israel.
Yeah, I'm not saying the information is inaccurate. Yeah, the Bible's just been rewritten.
But which Bible is real?
But
original Bible, the Bible actually, we wrote.
But
the
when
Bible,
you
black people wrote the Bible.
Of course, but where's that? Where's the original so we can read it?
King James was a so-called black man.
The original Bible is not... It's not, it doesn't say King James, it doesn't say Old Testament, it doesn't say New Testament.
You know that.
We know that.
Don't say none of that shit. The real original Bible, that what y'all read,
it's in Hebrew.
It's been taken and rewritten. They took out the parts that they rewrote that Bible that y'all got in. I studied world history. You never know who you're going to meet.
And actually,
I studied world history all my life.
And actually, though, when you do study the Hebrew and compare the Hebrew, the Old Testament, to the King James, you'd be surprised at how accurate it is. It's extremely accurate, and it's a very literal translation.
Yeah.
It's very accurate.
Don't let that discourage you from the message, man, because it's a message we're pushing out.
Oh, I know it's a message in the Bible. I read the Bible.
Because the Lord put His Spirit on the translators to give us this majestic book right here.
I believe in God. I just don't believe in society's version of God.
Of course.
We don't need it.
Because their God is Satan.
That's their God.
That's their God. It's the devil.
That's this world's God. And sometimes you see in the black churches, the dumb niggas, he got a tan. They make him look like he...
Like he Puerto Rican or something.
Right, he got a tan. But it's the same devil that just went to the same tanning booth. You know what I'm saying? Jake messed up, man. Jake all stupid.
Yeah, like that, right. The Lord's a dark-skinned man. Look, the Lord's a dark-skinned man. The Bible says...
This is the man Jesus was depicted from.
Right. And the Bible also says it's a shame for a man to have long hair. You know what I mean? But they got this long hair queer all up in their buildings. You know what I mean?
Long hair queer, right? And he was a queer.
He was. They said he had sexual relations with Leonardo da Vinci. He was one of his employees.
Yeah, he was here committing incest.
Yeah, had sex with his sister, Lucretia. The Borgia family.
Lucretia.
His dad was hitting that too, probably.
You seen the first crime family in Borgia years old, the new one? Lucretia fine, man.
That actress is fine.
Yeah, that she bad, man.
You know the real Lucretia is probably hideous.
Oh, yeah. You look at the old pictures of her, she is hideous.
Yeah.
They was artists back then.
Just like Cleopatra, they say she was beautiful. That bitch was ugly as hell.
Stink. There's writings about how she used to stink.
Because really, yeah. Because Lucretia could have been Cleopatra in the reincarnation. That's the same family. The same bloodline. Edomites.
Same devil.
They Edomites.
Hey, man, what's that in Caligula?
Whoever Caligula, that's my dude.
Dipping in the bowl of nut. You seen the movie Caligula?
It's on YouTube, bro. You gotta watch that movie.
You gotta watch it. It's on Caligula. YouTube?
Yeah, they got the whole movie on YouTube.
Oh, I didn't know that.
They got two of them.
It's showing all the shit?
It shows it all.
Oh, wow. That's bad, man. That's bad. I know they be, there's a YouTube channel you can buy movies for someone.
That one's free.
It's free. Wow. Yep. You might want to write that down.
Caligula. You know who Caligula is, right? The third Roman Caesar, Augustus.
Yeah.
He's the crazy motherfucker. He was whacked out of his head, made his horse a console.
He was a crazy one.
Yeah.
Straight up. He's asleep with his horse.
But that movie really breaks it down and shows you how these devils operate, though.
Right.
And how fucking evil they are.
Caligula.
Because America's Rome in the reincarnation. You know what I'm saying? That's why you look on the back of a dollar and you see everything's written in Latin. That's the language of the Romans. The main symbol is the eagle. That goes back to the Romans. Right, this right here is a Roman temple. Right in front of everybody. Nobody even notices it. And they got statues of naked children and pedophiles right in front. Go look at them statues, bro. Dude got his butt cheek showing, holding a naked boy. Right in front of their temple. They love their naked statues, though. They everywhere. They got two statues of Christopher Columbus.
That was Michelangelo was common for drawing naked ass pictures of the Lord and the Most High and angels.
The little ass penis.
I got some on my tablet too.
With that Sistine Chapel. It's just gay as hell, man.
Right, check it out. This is good about these devils, man.
The scriptures tell you they're a bunch of devils, though. There's a law in the Bible that says it's a shame to look on another man's nakedness. That's against the law. So you know that.
What happened to Noah's son? Looked at his nakedness.
You got cursed.
You read the Bible twice, right?
Yeah.
Noah's son, what happened? He looked at him naked. Ham walked in after the flood, let's settle. After going through that trauma, Noah and his sons and his sons' wives went through, man, that trauma, and that's a trauma to go through to see the whole world drown to death.
Yeah.
Definitely. After all the water succeeded, man, he got drunk.
And then he seen him naked and laughed at him.
Right. And so his son Ham, who was the progenitor of those filthy ass Africans, walked in and was looking at him, and we know through the spirit he's probably lusting after him a little.
Probably.
You know what I'm saying? Looked at him and he cursed Ham's son, the Canaanites, looking at his name.
That's heavy too, because you look at the Sistine Chapel, they depicting the Most High butt-ass nigga.
Yeah.
That tells you these churches are full of shit. But they know in secret, though, they really do worship the devil. Yeah, a lot of them's open with it now. Yeah, they pushing to make pedophilia legal now. They already made homosexuals legal. Now a man can marry a man.
That one right there. That's
the Most High got clothes on.
Yeah, but that's
still,
the Lord though.
But that's still gay as hell.
Yeah, that's supposed to be the Lord right there.
Yeah, Adam.
Or Adam. Yeah.
Yeah, Adam. Well, Adam is the Lord. Your house.
Yeah, reincarnation.
Yeah, they got all these little naked angels. That's just gay as hell.
Here's a snake. And that picture's going off too, because there's no accuracy about this picture. Look at this snake. The snake's it looks like a...
Yeah, because they tried... Because people actually believe that was a real snake. You know what I'm saying? It was actually a wicked person.
Some shit you're going to see at the carnival. That's what it looks like. Some people see it.
Hey, actually, get that Genesis 3. Let's read that. Cause that goes to the root of it all, right?
Oh, go ahead.
All right,
so 2 Corinthians 2:12-17. For we are not as many which corrupt the word of God, but as sincerity, but as God, in the sight of God, we speak we outside.
Right, we ain't corrupting the word of the Most High. Like, you got people, they teaching the Bible, but you'll never hear the word Israel come out their mouth. They ain't gonna tell you who the real Israelites are. That's because they don't know this book. You know what I'm saying? they either knowingly deceiving people or they just ignorant. They just teaching that same BS that pastor taught them. Pastor teaching them it's still lawful to eat pork.
A seminary school, what are they called?
Yeah, seminary school is a joke. I be dealing with people that went to them Bible schools and they don't be knowing the scripture. Some of them might know a couple words in Greek, you know what I mean? They might know a little something.
That's not the spirit of prophecy.
No, it's not the spirit of prophecy, right. You can't be taught prophecy. The Lord, well, you can be taught. You got to have to be taught by the right men. You know what I'm saying? You got to be of the elect.
So if y'all children ain't religious, what is all this? What is all this?
Spiritual.
We out here sighing and crying for all these abominations out here. Cursing out this wicked ass society.
Right. You see that spiritual gift.
Because if you hate this world, bro, you're supposed to come out here and curse this world out. You know what I'm saying?
Now, back to 12. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of the Most High. That's why now, this is answering the question about the idea. But when we speak, we see the spirit of the Most High.
We hate this world. We hate the spirit of the world.
So should you. You should hate it. You're a so-called, you're an Israelite. You're a so-called black man.
It's got
a so-called Negro. And we're targeted, aren't we? It's a fact that we're targeted, you know?
Because this world vexes our spirit, man. Every day we wake up, we living in hell. You know what I'm saying? This ain't nothing to like out here. There's nothing, nothing good out here.
This is a life of heathen. Because heathens, they don't have the law. The Lord don't deal with heathens, you know what I'm saying? This is their life. We want a kingdom where we can actually obey the law perfectly.
Right. Well, in America, they got like, what, 2 million laws? You can't walk down the street without breaking the law. But still, it's legal to break half the Ten Commandments. Like, adultery is one of the Ten Commandments. That's legal. A woman can cheat on you, bro. That Bible says she got to get put to death. But according to this world, she gets all your money. If you don't pay, you get locked up for child support.
The Bible says kill her and him.
Kill both of them. They both get put to death. And that's
kill
a right. That sounds harsh, but that's a righteous judgment.
Is that so we can put evil out of Israel?
Put evil away from Israel. That will put a fear in the hearts of people too. They gonna think twice when they do something evil. It's like, also one of the Ten Commandments is the Sabbath. There's no Sabbath day in America where the whole city shut down, you know what I'm saying? Once a week is supposed to be a day of rest for everybody. But these stores, they go 24/7, you know what I mean?
You know what to do with these stores?
Hey, they lose their mind, bro.
This is Deuteronomy 22:22. If a man be found lying with a woman married to an husband as girlfriend too.
Yeah, because ain't no such thing as girlfriends or boyfriends in the Bible. The husband and wife, that's it.
That's their excuse.
Because once you lay down with a woman, according to the law, as soon as you have sex with a woman, you and her become one. And that's your wife. Right, just like that. As soon as you lay down together, that's your wife.
And every infection she has.
Right. Yeah, so you lay down with a whore, you become one with all them other dudes she lay down with.
That's right. That's right. And that's a fact that you just want to take on these demons of everybody she lay down with. Everybody she opened her damn stupid ass quiver to, man.
Taking all them spirits inside of her. Because that sperm got spirits in it.
The Lord set that up.
Because when you want to get all these different sperms in them from all these different men, that's all kind of different spirits getting up in her. And it messes with, fucks with her mind. Yeah, that's why.
It plants something in her mind. Like, when we lay with her, something gets planted in our mind, too.
Yeah,
it does. It gets us connected.
Yep.
You know, it's an automatic connection. So that's why you see all these bitches going crazy on all kind of psycho drugs. Because they've been sleeping with every Tom, Dick, and Harry. And they wondering why they keep doing stupid shit and why they going crazy, man. Actually, the world wondering why this bitch is doing stupid shit that she is. Just look at YouTube, man. Look at the black woman. Look at her, man. You ain't gotta go to YouTube. Just walk around. Am I right? Just walk around. Talk to her, man.
It's crazy out here.
You know? And they raising the children without the father around? Damn, what's that formula come up with?
Men growing up effeminate. You know what I mean?
It's crazy, man. If a man be found lying with a woman married to a husband, then they shall both of them die. Both the man that lay with the woman and the woman, so shalt thou put away evil from Israel.
They'll put away evil from my people, man. That's like the scriptures say, somebody commits an act of murder. In this piece of society, they don't lock you up behind bars for like 30 years. That's some sick shit to do to a human being anyway, throw them in prison. There ain't no prisons in the Bible, you know what I mean? But if somebody murders somebody, you're just supposed to kill them. That's it, you ain't supposed to lock them up. You know why they lock them up though? They get free slave labor out of them. They couldn't legally still have slaves right out in the open like that. So, you know, they get the prisons is just an extension of the slave labor.
The devil is supposed to have changed. Remember?
Right.
He got rid of slavery.
That's that veil he put
on. That's clever as hell.
What they call that? That's that facade.
Yeah. I remember seeing that too. It's Cincinnati for like this little, like a slavery type museum type shit. It's like show part of the Constitution, whatever the fuck it was. It said that if you go to prison,
it is. They sell stocks for these prisons on the stock market. That's big business. Big business.
People getting locked up there. So he's counting on niggas. He's looking forward to niggas committing more and more.
So that's why if any of our people call the cops, that's our enemy. That's the enemy. You know what I mean? The cops are the enemy. You know what I'm saying? And if our people ever call the cops, that's the enemy.
That's the enemy.
And it's, we got scripture to prove that.
That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right.
Because our people love. Because our people love them. Man, these people, they're a bunch of bootlicking. What's that word? What are you looking for?
Okay, let me find it. First Corinthians?
First Corinthians 6:1.
Okay. Yeah, that's it. Check it out, bro. First Corinthians 6:1. This is Spirit how we're rapping about this one. Dare any of you having a matter against another, go to the law before the unjust and not before the saints.
Right, because that's what they do. Because law of the unjust means go to the so-called authorities. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they like to call themselves the authorities.
The saints is
the church. It's
we're
the
supposed
Israel.
To be dealing with our own issues as a nation.
We're supposed to handle our own business.
We look like fools going to the enemy for justice.
Because what happens every time you call the cops? You call the cops, they're going to come and lock you up.
Lock you up.
Shit, you might get shot. That might be your last day.
Oh, that's been happening a lot lately. Yeah. Like the dude up last week, he called the cops because somebody's breaking in his crib. They blow his ass away.
That's how it always goes, man.
Well, he probably heard the scripture, though.
Probably
you know,
so.
He probably heard the scripture, though. And he just condemned himself, calling the cops. Shit, it's my pleasure, man, to deal with it on myself. My own, man.
Yeah, you ain't lying.
You know what I'm saying? Right, man. My mouth will start drooling, man. Coming, man, you know what I mean? You live with your woman and your children and shit, man. Somebody coming to crib, looking to take from you. And that's what people MO, man, wanting what they don't belong to them, man. It's my pleasure, man, to take a bat upside their head.
Gotta
wait for it. Gotta wait, right.
And then after the cops, by the cops get there, everybody's dead already.
Nigga done crawled away.
They show up in time to draw that chalk line, like, oh, another one bites some dust.
Like, cops never come on time. They always come like 30 minutes later.
Never prevent shit.
No, they're not trying to get shot.
Never prevent nothing.
Right. Like, what you see. You're like, what the fuck? What's going to happen?
Man, fuck these cops.
All right, I got a question. If Jesus is a Negro, but we are not, what is this going on here?
Let me show you something.
But like he said, there's all kind of nations in the Bible. And, hey, get Exodus 11:7. Well, who's the Egyptians?
Who did that to Jesus?
Who what?
Who did that to Jesus?
Who did that to Jesus?
That's not Jesus. That's the devil.
Jesus is a black man.
Jesus is a black man. That's the devil.
You ain't trying to hear that, huh? Huh, devil?
You guys sure are going pretty far-fetched with this shit.
Yeah, you done lost your goddamn mind, devil. That's why you stink.
Why you gotta call her a devil?
You should come up here disrespectful.
That's disrespectful.
Look, there is a devil to reject the Lord being what he is.
She's disrespecting the Son of Man.
Yeah.
Get him.
But that's just a lady, though.
But she was disrespectful. The Lord said there's no respect for persons, bro.
Hey, the Lord said kiss the Son, he see me angry.
Let me get that script.
First John 4, yeah. 4:1, I'm pretty sure it's 4:1.
Shit, she's scared.
She said, y'all going pretty damn far with this shit.
And she was very rude, though. If she would have came up in a humble spirit, we would have been cool. Like, nah, girl, that's not the Lord, you know what I mean? But she had to come up with that proud-ass, wicked spirit, bro. She had demons on her. That's the only way you can curse some demons. You got to curse these fools out when they act like that.
Do I got demons on me?
First of all, she shouldn't be talking.
We don't know yet.
You being respectful.
Right.
You didn't come up in that proud spirit like her. She came up in that old satanic demon woman spirit.
Nah, that's good. That's good. Yeah, he asked a question about this. This is a definition. This is a Bible dictionary. Right? In fact, the definition of Ham. Okay, this is Ham. Ham, the youngest son of Noah, born probably about 96 years before the flood, and one of eight persons to live through the flood.
Now, Ham is the, like he's about to tell you, Ham is like the Egyptians were Hamites. The Cushites are Hamites. Go ahead. What's up, Legion? That's your boy, he been chilling in the cemetery, you know what I'm saying?
That's
an ancient.
I know it is, man. We get entertained watching people out here, man. People watching, man. We get entertained too, man. They entertained by us as much as we entertain.
Hey, let's get that. Read that again, though. Check this out, though. This is some real shit right here.
And one of eight persons to live through the flood.
This is talking about Ham. Go ahead.
He became the progenitor of the dark races.
No, Ham is the progenitor, the forefather of the dark races. Keep going.
Not the Negroes. But the Egyptians. The motherfucker that's in the Sudan right now.
Yeah, that's the Egyptians, the Sudanese. Right. Modern day Sudanese is the ancient Egyptians.
They got pushed out by the white
man. And when you look at them, you can tell they look just like the statues and everything.
Right. They sure do, just like.
So they built the pyramids?
No, we built it. We were slaves under them.
Yeah. I've been to Egypt.
We had the wisdom.
I've been to Egypt.
The Israelites, they didn't do it. We're
in Egypt right now.
I've been to Egypt. I've been to the real Egypt. I walked on the pyramids. And they still live there. White folks don't live in Egypt.
There's some Arabs over there.
Okay.
There ain't black people in Egypt. Those are Arabs.
But black people invented
Muhammad's people conquered all of that shit.
Right.
Exodus 1 and 8.
Now there rose up a new king over Egypt, and there was knew not Joseph.
Joseph was an Israelite.
I got to put that out, sorry. And he said unto his people, behold, the people of the children of Israel are more and mightier than we.
This is the new king that come up over the children of Israel. See, we were under captivity then. Okay, go ahead, bro.
Come on, let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply, and it come to pass that when they fall out of any war, they join also unto our enemies and fight against us, and so get them out of our land. Therefore they did set over them taskmasters to afflict them with their burdens, and they built for Pharaoh treasure cities.
They built the treasure cities.
Yeah, they built the treasure cities.
That was us to say.
All them statues.
We're bad people, man.
But you know them. You can tell the Egyptians were like evil tyrants. That's why they was known for building giant statues of their leaders. Now what kind of people puts giant statues of themselves up everywhere? Like, you see Kim Jong-il, Kim Jong-un, got posters of himself on the wall, Vladimir Lenin, posters of himself everywhere. You know, that's something a tyrant does. He wants you to worship him as he's God. Even the Pharaoh had commanded the people to worship him as he was God. He was considered to be Horus in the flesh. You know what I'm saying? That's what you call a tyrant. And you can see that's why they had Israel in slavery for 400 years.
That's right. And can you imagine, man? I mean, we had technology, man, that above you. We had the internet back then, the computer internet. You ever heard of that?
Nah.
Yeah, man, they had technology.
That's in the Bible,
in the ancient world.
That's in the Bible.
Well, all the modern mathematics come from them ancient Greek manuscripts.
It wasn't for everybody. You know what I mean? Can't give it to every fool, man. Because just like they do now, they watch bestiality with the internet. Instead of looking for wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, they're looking at porn, they're looking to upload videos of them fingering their cat or them on vacation. Doing stupid shit.
Yep.
You know? But the internet was given to us to spread this word. Man.
That's why we flood the internet with videos. You know what I mean? We uploaded thousands and thousands of videos.
Can you imagine knowing the shit, man, that he built, man? The technology behind it? He built an ark that took in all the animals, man. That's crazy, man.
What's up, bro?
And it was technology behind it. You know, as far as splitting genes and and crossbred shit. They was doing that shit back then, man.
Fucking minotaurs.
Right,
shit.
All kind of monsters, right, giants. And they was going, they was getting crazy with it, you know? So the Lord said, okay, I'm gonna fix these fools. We got rid of them, you know? And you find the archaeology, they digging up the shit everywhere for proof, you know?
There was giants back then.
Right, it's probably giants school. There is giants.
Oh, there is giants.
So Nikembe Mutombo is a giant.
Yep.
You know?
Sloth.
Oh, yeah. Y'all saw all. Jeez.
Giant sloth.
Yeah. Shit nasty.
Right. Okay, let's get back into this.
Can't catch it, though. You're too slow.
Right. He became the progenitor of the dark races, not the Negroes, but the Egyptians, Ethiopians, Libyans, and Canaanites.
Not the Negro. Why would they put that in the, that's a white man that wrote that book.
Right.
Why would he put that in that book? And that's a popular Bible dictionary. What's that, the Zondervan? Zondervan's one of the top publishers of, you know, Bible commentary. Bible. He publishes Bibles. Like, why? They know something that we don't, that these average people don't know.
That's right.
They know something.
Where's that? Does make a difference between? I got it right.
Why you think back? Why you think back in the slavery days that you had something called Negro spirit?
So you know?
And they was always singing about Israel, and they had that song like "Sweet Chariot, Come to Carry Me Home." They was talking about, and where did he say over the River Jordan? And they going back to the scriptures.
That's Israel.
And they was praying for the Lord to come out of the sky with them chariots and take them home, because that was the only salvation. That's the only way they could get up out of there.
Let's
know it again. Exodus 11 and 7, but against any of the children of Israel, shall not a dog move his tongue, against man or beast, that you may know that Yahweh doth put a difference between the Egyptian and Israel.
The Lord doth put a difference between Egyptians and Israel.
That people love to think they're the same, but they're not the same. That's why Moses went to Pharaoh, let my people go. You know what I'm saying? Over and over again, let my people go.
You know, it's funny. Black people, the only thing they claim is Egyptian. But it's probably a different nation.
Yeah. But you got Kushites too. The Kush ain't even. They related, but they're not even.
Shit, one nigga you know that claims that he's what's they call it? Somali? Yeah, Somali.
Why my people come from Somali?
They want to be like Michael Jordan or Tyson or Tupac. Yeah. But ain't none of us just claiming one of them by name. But actually, they are.
Yeah, but they know Tupac coming out of Somali, though.
Right.
Where's the Tupac Michael Jordan at coming out dunking on everybody? It don't exist, because it's not the same people. They're not capable. The Lord gave them a different spirit.
Yeah.
Their spirit was to shoot you with an AK.
You walk in their club, you don't see them getting down. You see, they dancing.
Yeah, going like that ball on them.
There's a video on YouTube that they all, it's a whole bunch of men dancing together.
They be grabbing each other's junk, too.
Man, that's loud, man. And another thing, you want to remember, try and watch the documentary called Mongo Magic.
Whew.
And it's all about them handbags. Oh, nothing, man. There ain't nothing going on, man. This ain't for everybody. It's just out here breathing the scriptures, man.
Why ain't everybody? If I believe, I believe.
No, I ain't saying you. I'm just saying this ain't for everybody. Just reading the scriptures. Well, where you going if it's for you? See, it ain't for you. See, it ain't for you.
See, the spirit, the spirit is something else. Once the Holy Spirit hits you, bro, you see shit other people don't see.
What's that movie called with Roddy Piper?
Oh, They Live.
They Live.
You see that with
glasses on?
They can see the aliens.
Are they burning this man?
Yeah, you ain't never seen that before. All this time, nigga, you've been coming out here.
Exactly, I know.
My eyes is closed.
I'm sorry, like, the biggest thing that's, like, over here is, like, because it's my eye.
Oh, wow. Well, we the Israelites and we the last days, and that's why we're out here, to pave the way for the Lord, man. So when he comes, and when that hell starts hitting, they ain't gonna have no excuse for not knowing. Because we out here in the midst of everybody, so you ain't gotta talk to us. That's how strict the Lord is. You ain't gotta talk to us. As long as you get your eye by the floor, as long as you set your eyes on the prophets of the Lord, that's all it takes, man. You know?
I got a preset too, just so we're going into Israel. I'm gonna show you the importance of Israel, though.
Oh, it's President's Day too. What y'all got for that?
We got enough for that.
But watch, Matthew 15 and 24. This is what the Lord said about Israel, though. He said, "But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel."
That's on my hood, the Lord.
Because that's something else they're not going to teach in the church. It's because the Lord only came for the nation of Israel.
You know about red letters? In the Bible?
Yeah, that's
red letters. The red letters. Yeah. What is it?
Red letters.
No, what is the red letters?
I don't know.
The red letters is the Lord speaking himself.
Like the one they call Jesus.
Right. His name is Yahweh Shah. That's his Hebrew name, Yahweh Shah. So when you see red letters in the Bible, that's him speaking.
Because you like, people love to say they're Egyptian or whatever, but the Lord didn't come to save Egyptians.
Right.
He came to save Israel. You know what I mean?
Here's what I understand. Right. If the red letters are the Lord, who knows who the fuck the Lord is?
We know who the Lord is.
How?
The Spirit.
Who met God and lived the fucking televised?
He sucked through us through the Spirit.
But that's what you got to think about it. But look, that's why you got four different accounts of the same story. You got Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Witnesses.
And there's a little different stuff in each one of them, but there's four different accounts. You know what I'm saying? So you got other books, like you got the Quran. That's just one account written by one guy. When they said Muhammad wrote it, but he was illiterate. Go figure that out. But the Bible's got numerous accounts, you know what I'm saying, of the same story. So that's four different witnesses. The Bible said in the mouth of two or three witnesses, let everything be established. There's four witnesses right there. Plus, many thousands. There's been more books written on the one they call Jesus than any person has ever lived. You know, even time is based on it. This year is the year 2017. Damn. A.D. Anno Domini, the year of our Lord. So even time itself is based on this book.
Yeah.
And they get mad, too. Now they're trying to change it. Now they're trying to say this is the year C.E., the common era. You know what I mean? They're trying to change it. They want you to, they're trying to get that out of people's minds. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
It is no doubt the one they call Jesus lived. There's no doubt about that.
This is Romans 8. I'm going to start at 19. No, 18. For I reckon, the point is way down to the 60. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For earnest expectations of the creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of the Most High.
Manifestation of the Son. See, now we're being made manifest. Because now the Spirit revealed who the sons of the Most High is, which is the nation of Israel. You know, we can tell who an Israelite is through the Spirit. We can just tell. Because when you go around a heathen spirit.
I could have started there.
Yeah.
You know.
Because our spirits don't mess with a heathen spirit. But we can tell a Jake, regardless of what he looks like, just like, man, we got a cool-ass spirit. You know what I mean?
It's like your eyes, man. That's how we know you check your eyes.
Yeah, the eyes are the window to the soul.
That's how we know you're a brother. See, we can get drunk together and hang out and talk about bitches. You know what I'm saying?
The Israel like to talk shit, like to drink and talk shit. Right. That's one of many characteristics of an Israelite.
Right. Like heathen looking at dopey walking by. You know, a woman walk by with fat ass, they don't see it.
Nah. He said, don't. That's true, though, man.
It's true, though.
It is.
You gotta watch it.
Especially Esau. Esau is a big homosexual.
Yeah.
The so-called white people just ruined the earth. But not all white people are the same.
I was going to say, with Shaka Zulu, man, him and his boys, he used to raise the morale of the tribe. He used to have them fuck each other.
That's not even a secret.
Right. Just have them fuck each other, man. Make each other.
But you got people talking about they were down with the Zulu nation.
Right. The Hamites and Canaanites, when their sons turned 12 years old, they popped their sons, man. To get them used to manhood.
That's what Esau
does,
too.
Just behind that.
That new so-called Jews.
Yeah.
Now you ain't gonna fuck your son when he turns 12.
Hey, Sean.
I know you're not. You know? Because that's us. We're Jews.
Right here.
That's where they come from.
That's where Edomite. That's the head house of Esau. It's these devils. They're trying to claim they're Jews. This is what they do to their children when they get circumcised.
That's a picture speaks for itself. Look at the baby crying. Look at the baby crying, man. Like,
they circumcise it.
Look at that baby.
Then a rabbi sucks the blood out of it.
Babies in horror, man.
That goes
catching
on in every
AIDS and shit.
That's part of their customs. That's not in the script.
And they learned it.
I ain't never seen no shit like that.
And they learned it from the ancient Babylonians, the Africans.
Yeah, they really did. Because Esau don't got nothing original.
Right.
He copies the other heathens.
It's crazy. He's a filthy people, man.
Because Esau is a so-called white man.
Oh,
the devil, the Bible speaks.
I'm gonna hold that. told that.
See, right here, children. I gotta get a shirt. We gotta fix this.
It might be in the back, but we got one.
I got one in the back of the book. And why are you getting that to? Oh, you got something already?
Yeah, I got it.
I'll go ahead.
This is Psalms 147 and 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob.
Who's Jacob? Jacob's name was changed to Israel. He wrestled with an angel, and the angel changed his name to Israel. And Israel means he's the prince of God, right? And that's who he's the father of the 12 tribes. Go ahead.
He showeth his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He hath not dealt so with any nation.
He had not dealt so with any nation. Go ahead.
And as for his judgments, they have not known them.
And you can see it too, because they don't follow the Lord's commandments. In America, they don't follow the Lord's commandments out here. Like I said, they got, 2 million laws? You can be a faggot. Faggots can get married. You know what I'm saying?
It's crazy, man. Bitches are getting dykes marrying the show and adopting children.
We live in a country where whoever got the most money gets out of jail. Like if a poor man and a rich man get charged with the same crime, we already know the poor guy can't afford an attorney. He making a deal with the prosecutor. He's getting the book thrown at him. You know what I mean?
Literally.
Why these devils, they can murder somebody and get probation. That's not justice. That's not godly. You know what I'm saying? That's why this shit got to be destroyed. All this shit got to be destroyed. The Lord going to destroy all of this shit. Everything you see is all going to be destroyed. And that destruction is coming. You watching the news, you see all that talk about war with Russia going down. And that's going to be the end of it right there, bro. The missiles. Soon the missiles is going to hit.
I think it's going to be some type of fucking virus or something.
Well, that too. Because you see they push that vibration in all the TV shows. All these shows about viruses.
Zombies and shit.
All this reality.
They preparing people's minds to get them ready for it.
Yeah.
What do they call that? Predictive programming. Yeah. That's what's going down, bro. Go ahead.
Matthew 24:6. And he shall hear wars and rumors of wars. See that you be not troubled, for all these days must come to pass. The end is not yet. The nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines, pestilences, earthquakes in diverse places. All these are the beginning of sorrow.
I heard it. Somebody on the news just said that over the west coast of the United States, there's like a giant lava pool just chilling underneath the United States.
Yeah, they're saying, actually got a video on lava spewing out like a faucet.
Yeah.
It's shooting out like a faucet, which you always run out. It was shooting out. Like
well, that too. They say they were worried about that for years.
Because you know what's going to happen.
Yeah. They say it's been acting for years.
They're going to blow.
But they're going to do it themselves, though.
Yeah, they probably will.
The weather machines. That's a weather machine. They call them earthquake machines that can cause earthquakes and shit. It's hard. You ever heard of hard? HARP. It's a weather machine that they use up in Alaska.
Because I heard a HARP expert, the guy who actually worked for HARP, break it down. He said it don't work. It shoots shit into the ground.
Right.
And then it goes back up.
Up to the ionosphere, stratosphere.
Yeah.
And it keeps bouncing back and forth, heating up more and more. And it goes, man, that's crazy. It's just crazy, man. But anyway, that's what they probably going to beam onto that area and make it blow up or whatever, you know. And HARP is just an acronym, which means High Frequency Active Auroral Research Program, which actually, it ain't HARP no more, because HARP is just the research part of them perfecting the real one. The real one is in motion now.
Plus, Russia got their shit too.
Yeah, Russia, China.
They've been having weather wars for years and years between Russia and America.
Yeah. There's a big weather storm out west. They call it Lucifer. It's going to be hitting for 7 days out west. 7 days, man. That's crazy how 7 days.
Now hopefully that dam breaks out there in California.
Hopefully it does. Yeah.
Drowns all them bastards.
Lucifer. That's what they named it, Lucifer.
Lucifer.
Yeah, they named it Lucifer, man. Fucking Lucifer. They named the storm Lucifer.
But you know what Lucifer means, though, right? The light bearer. That's what it really means.
Right. So it's telling us that it's somebody behind the scenes.
Yeah. But the Illuminati.
It ain't the devil, because Lucifer is not Satan.
Nah.
That's what everybody thinks. Yeah. Everybody thinks. Let me read this. This is 2 Ezra 13:48. But those that be left behind of thy people are they that are found within my borders. Now when he destroyeth the multitude of the nations that are gathered together, he shall defend his people that remain. And then shall he showeth them great wonders. Which is going to be destruction.
Yeah.
And only Israel's going to.
Yeah, like we said earlier, ultimately the way we're going to get delivered is by them chariots.
UFOs. UFOs.
You know anything about them UFOs?
And that sign, a giant, massive UFO.
I ain't never seen no UFOs.
Seriously, I seen one time.
I believe shit, some shit happens.
Right.
Well, shit would definitely happen, though.
That's cool. Well, it's too late for you, man. When it happens.
Now, that's why we're talking to you. Wake you up now.
But really, all you gotta do is go outside. It's hard to see shit in the city at nighttime. If you go, I mean, if you can go out on a nice, clear night, if you look up, you're gonna see some bugged out shit going on up there.
Turn the porch light off. Just turn some.
Most people don't take the time to look because it's going on right in front of you, and you'll see shit flying like it'll just stop.
That's why it's all lit all across this country. It's so lighting and lit country. So we can't really see. If you turn the lights on, you can see everything.
That's all you gotta do. And if people ain't occupied, everybody looking around.
Ain't nobody
everybody
ever
concerned
looking
about what's going on anyway.
I'm into the stars too. I like looking in the stars. Try you look. You know what I mean? It's just amazing to me.
Right. Give the women freedom and liberty to put to take their clothes off. You know. So everybody looking at the women and shit, stinking ass women with fat asses and shit like that. Anybody think about spiritual things up there, man?
Because the book of Genesis even said to use the stars for signs.
Everybody looking around for drama because niggas is around. Because when niggas is around, you gotta expect drama to happen. So everybody's always worried about what's around here, man. Not up there. You know?
Hey, what was that one scripture that said, look up?
Look up. That's Luke. I got it. Let me get it.
You know what that said?
Luke 21:22.
We could go on the stage on it. The Bible is like a UFO handbook. You know what I mean? They go.